Get ready to match the stars. Peter Isaacson, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Johnny O, thank you, dear friends at Dentalheart. Are you all ready? I must point out to you that this lanky fellow here is the first time on his show. Peter Isaacson, he's one of the stars of CPO Sharky, big hit show, starring Don Rickles, and he's only 22 years old, and it's disgusting.
No.
He's disgusting.
Disgusting.
22 years old and a big hit already. Get off this stage. How long can he last? We welcome you one and all. Would you in turn welcome Janelle Moore and Sandra Lee? How much money have you won?
$600.
$600?
I think.
Okay. How do you feel about that?
Oh, I feel wonderful.
It's better to win than to lose, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Good. And Sandra, how are you?
Fine.
Are you ready to carry on? You didn't do too good with your first one.
No.
Remember, the first round ones are tough. She's got a tough one coming up in a moment or so, but right now we've got this coming up for you. Here we go. I'll push a button and reveal your first round question, Janelle. Remember, it's a toughie. At the Alaskan party.
How is that?
They served Alaskan punch. That's a big bowl of punch with a blank floating in it. That's what Alaskan punch is. There you are, sir.
I know.
Take note of that. Oh, you know. You got it. Okay.
He woke up for a moment.
Well, they didn't take too much time with that, did they, Janelle?
No, we've all been to Alaska a lot.
I see. While Charles is writing, I'll ask it of you. At the Alaskan party, they served Alaskan punch. Now, that's a big bowl of punch with a blank floating in it.
An Eskimo.
An Eskimo. Don't groan. Now, don't groan. One of these weirdos might say Eskimo. You never know. Okay.
Why did you look at me when he said that?
I didn't need to look at you. I was saying just general direction. Wave my arm there, Peter.
I thought something a little larger to put in your glass. An iceberg.
An iceberg. Yep.
What did you say? One of those weirdos might say something
Eskimo.
Like that?
Yes, I said that.
I think that's a wonderful answer. A fabulous answer.
Yes,
come on.
It is. There it is. Thank you, Jaloo, my dear.
Yes. It's interesting someone so warm and talented should be sitting between two icebergs.
Yes. Okay. An Alaskan party. Served Alaskan punch. It's a big bowl of punch with a blank floating in it. And she said Eskimo.
Did you ever see a polar bear do the backstroke? Because you could there.
Oh, yeah.
Polar bear.
Polar bear.
Polar bear.
That'd be some big bowl, wouldn't it, Richard?
Yes, sir. Two Eskimos ago.
There we go. Two of Janelle.
Sorry, sweetheart. I thought iceberg.
Iceberg.
Yes.
Okay, so there is two for you, and that's the end of round one, and that's the score. 2-0 at the end of round one. We go to round two, Sandra.
B again, please.
Okay, you've got it. Everybody plays.
B for blue.
Poor Sally.
My word.
I don't think I'll even tell you about her. I guess I better. Instead of taking birth control pills, she took vitamin C tablets. 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound blank. You didn't hear it. Poor Sally. Instead of taking birth control pills, she took vitamin C tablets, and 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound blank. Don't say it yet, because two of them are still writing. Got it, Chuck?
Yo.
Okay. Fanny, you got it? Okay.
My word.
9 months later, she gave birth. Hold everything.
Fanny, hurry up. Good gravy, Marie.
Doubleday is going to publish it, too.
Later, 9 months later, she gave birth to a 6-pound blank.
Cold. That's all I can think of.
Really?
I can't think of nothing.
You remember the question? Instead of taking birth control pills, she took vitamin C. Well, you did. You understood it. But in a way, you didn't understand it. Or you never would have said what you said. What do you say?
A 6-pound something look like Anita Bryant. An orange.
An orange! They're loaded with vitamin C, aren't they? What do you say?
Oh, honey, I'm sorry. I thought it was a shoe-in. I said orange.
I guess that's what we're going to get, a lot of oranges here.
Another orange.
So far, we have 3 oranges. That's 1/4 of a dozen. What do you make it, Mary?
Another orange.
Another orange. 5 oranges. Richard?
4 oranges. Sure.
4 oranges. Oh, you got to match both of the remaining celebrities to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Here we go.
Orange.
So that means Janelle wins the game. All right. Here we go. Okay. You hang around there for a moment or so.
It was fun.
Well, I'm glad you had a good time.
I had a good time meeting everybody.
Good for you, Sandra. We'll have some gifts for you and our thanks for being on Match Games 77. Okay. There she goes. Now, Janelle here has upped her earnings a little bit. You're up to $700. You could win a big bundle here. Let's see what happens. We polled a recent studio audience, Janelle. We got their best response to this. Belle of Blank. Remember, you get $500 if you match the answer the studio audience gave most often. $250 for their second most popular answer, and then $100 for the third. And you are allowed to call on 3 of our 6 celebrities and solicit answers from them.
Fanny.
Something that Brett always is, the belle of the ball.
Belle of the ball.
That's
very sweet.
Charles.
A play that's in Chicago now and then going on, a play that was made possible by most of the Match Game people who put up the money, the second year of the Belle of Amherst.
The Belle of Amherst. Okay, you got 2 now.
Richard.
A play that currently is in Atlanta. Appearing twice a week, Thursdays and Fridays, the Belle of New Orleans.
The Belle of New Orleans.
Charles's sister is starring in it.
I see. So there are the 3.
We're
now,
not there.
Let's talk about these. The Belle of Amherst, the Belle of New Orleans, and the Belle of the Ball.
Yes, right.
Now, have you got a better idea, or do you want one of those?
I want Belle of the Ball.
You want there the Belle of the Ball. Fanny's answer. There may be others, but we'll find out if that one is up there. We'll begin at the bottom as usual, and we will reveal the $100 response. Belle of St. Mary's. Not a bad answer.
The Bells of St.
Bells,
Mary.
It isn't an E on the end.
Yeah, but we had a bunch of drinking dummies in there.
They must have been drunk, yeah.
May we see the $250 number? Belle of the South.
What on earth does that mean?
Well, the New Orleans in the South.
It's New
Orleans. Yes. The play I mentioned.
Oh, boy. It's weird time. May we see the big one, if you please?
Belle of the North.
Hey. Good girl, you did it by Joe.
Good.
He's good for you.
Now, listen to me. You picked up another $500, going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. And we'll give you the money if you match one celebrity.
Richard.
Richard.
Is that what you want? Is that what you say? Richard.
I don't want you to say anything.
Oh.
Well, I mean, I'm not asking you. I'm not forcing you to say Richard. You say anything you want. You want to say Richard?
Yes, I'll say Richard.
Say Richard.
Richard.
Thank you. I thought you'd never say it.
The play is just folded, I heard.
Now, this is worth a lot of money to this lady. Ready?
Okay.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Della Blank. That's D-E-L-L-A Blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, Janelle, give us an answer that matches his. You pick up an additional $5,000 here. Della Blank.
Della Reese.
Della Reese. Della Reese, she says.
That's amazing.
Why?
I think of Della of New Orleans.
Della of New Orleans. Alias Reese. Your sister's very happy for you out there. Both of them. Oh, boy, oh, boy, is she happy. Brings tears of joy to her eyes, and while she's crying and celebrating, you watch these messages. And a girl. Let us all welcome our new player here, Mr. Larry Lawrence. Larry. Hello there.
Fine.
Good.
A little nervous, but...
Listen, we're all a little nervous, Larry. Let's hear the Larry Lawrence story, as much as you want to tell us.
Well, I originally came from New Hampshire.
Yeah.
And I understand that it's quite cold out there,
as it
is all over.
Yes, I've had a severe winter.
And then I came down to New York.
Yeah.
Did a few stints down there, such as work, which we all have to do, and then came out here. Lived around and finally settled in Burbank.
Oh, boy. Don't tell us your troubles, Larry.
That's a life.
Yeah. When you say you did a stint, what does that mean? You work at various things?
Yes, I was a singer and a dancer.
I see.
And worked in several shows.
Okay.
And then I wound up in the garment business.
You've done a little of everything. You've had a full life, haven't you?
Not yet.
Oh, all right.
But there is one thing. I'm very happily single.
I see. Okay. Mm-hmm. That's the way it is. All right. Anything you say, Larry, is okay with us. You may have a choice here of A or B.
B, please.
You want B. New game. Everybody plays? Okay. The surgeon said to Stella.
Stella?
No, he said... He says, that's right.
No.
I can take out your appendix and leave no scar whatsoever. You see, I take your appendix out through your blank. Surgeon said to Stella, that's right. I can take your appendix out and leave no scar whatsoever. You see,
I had that same.
I take your appendix out through your blank. Leaves no scar. No scar.
Now that's the right answer, right?
What's that?
That's the right answer.
Come on now, Peter. Write something on a card.
Okay.
Put something on a card. Concentrate.
Where's your actor's concentration?
I never had it.
22. You're only 22 years old.
I'm positive.
That's disgusting. Nobody's 22 anymore. Is anybody 22 anymore?
I am.
You wish.
All right. Are you ready, Larry?
Yes.
The surgeon said to Stella, that's right, I can take out your appendix and leave no scar whatsoever. You see, I take your appendix out through your blank.
A mouth.
Yeah! Okay. That indeed requires a long scalpel.
Or a coat hanger.
Right. A coat hanger will do
from
it.
This surgeon, boy.
Yeah.
I had the same operation.
Show and tell. Hit her back if she hits you.
I'm going to. I'm bigger than she is.
Yes.
I said mouth.
Mouth is good. Are you standing up to him?
Stand up.
Wait a second.
Oh, golly, I feel like Annie, get your gun.
You look like death of a salesman.
Got that joke. The show business joke.
Why don't you stop dyeing your hair? I thought, well, they can actually do this. Mabel, they're doing
it. Mabel is good close by. Yes.
For what it's worth, Enzo Stuarti's real name is Larry Lawrence. Mouth.
Enzo Stuarti.
His real name is Larry Lawrence. Some of the showbiz stories.
Isn't that fascinating? Aren't you glad you tuned in, monkey? You see, no scar whatsoever. I take your appendix out through your...
This is a costume ball, isn't it?
Yeah.
Mouth.
Mouth it is. There's another one for Larry. What do you got there, Rich?
I think mouth is for gallstones. Ear.
Ear would be very difficult. Very difficult.
Well,
Fanny?
I said nose.
Through the nose. Well, you picked up three, which is quite unusual and very good for a first rounder because they are tough. We'll see what happens with you after we see what happens.
In any store.
Now we are at the other half of round one. Janelle, this is yours. Listen carefully. Everybody plays. Luigi says, you telling me, Mama Cabrelli, how come all of your pizzas are so unusual? And Mama Cabrelli said, it's easy. Before I bake it a pizza, I blank on it. That's why that a pizza is so unusual. Before I bake it a pizza, I blank on it.
I don't want to hurt your feelings, but that is the only anti-Semitic Italian accent I have ever heard.
You don't like my accent, huh?
Oh, it's wonderful.
I'm going to punch you in the nose.
Not till we get to Encino.
Oh. I'm going to get the whip out there.
Was your mother born in Ireland?
You're touching my knee.
Oh, idiot.
Ready? Before I bake it a pizza, I blank on it. I like it, whatever you're doing to me there. Take your time there.
All right.
You don't want to hurry you,
do you? No, don't want to hurry you. Your mother just fell asleep in the first row, Peter.
Yeah. Who's mother? Peter's mother's right there.
Peter's mother's in the first row, definitely. All right. Okay, here we go. Luigi said, tell me, Mama Cabrelli, how come all of your pizza is so unusual? And Mama Cabrelli said, it's easy. Before I bake a pizza, I blank on it.
Sit on it.
I sit on it. Right. What do you say to that?
I say that's a nice. It is a pizza so good, she gonna sit on it.
Sit on it. There's a one for her. What do you say?
Well, I say
her. What?
Sit on it.
All right.
She sits on it because it needs the dough better and makes the medium pizza a larger with a sausage.
With a sausage, okay. Hey, you're going very well here. Score is now tied 3-3. Now we come to Marie.
Right, she's a sit on it.
Well, that's a 4 for you. You gonna make a 5, a little boy?
I'm gonna make a 5.
Not a boy, a little boy. What about you, little girl?
Follow the crowd, Bob.
You did it. Got them all. Well, bing. Here we go. Now, Larry, you may have A or B.
Give her the whole box.
Give her the whole box. Just because you won $6,000, you keep crying all through the show.
I know, it's horrible.
Okay, Larry.
I'll go with B again.
B again. Now, you got to match all three remaining celebrities to achieve a tie and stay in the game. That's the best you can do. You cannot win this game. Brett? And what's his name?
Dickie.
And what's her name? All three of you play. Right.
Tawanda.
Tawanda. Okay. Sally the hitchhiker said to Harry, hey, mister, can you give me a lift?
Yes.
So Harry lifted her blank.
Yeah.
Like that one, eh, Peter? I just saw you're not playing this one.
Yeah, I'll write it anyway.
Because I'll give it anyway and show it to me. I'll go up and just take a little peek at it there. Yeah. All right.
Does that come from Orange County?
Oh, you see. Okay. As soon as Brett is ready.
Oh, I'm ready as rain.
Okay, Larry. Sally the hitchhiker said to Harry, hey, mister, can you give me a lift? So Harry lifted her blank.
Boobs.
I don't think that's what she had in mind. Really? Do you play?
Yes, I play. Oh, yeah, I thought I'd covered every single...
Gotta match everyone now, Larry.
Solid. I feel terrible. I said dress, or end or skirt, or muumuu, or wrapper. I thought I had covered all
that didn't do it, and that means Janelle wins another game. Skirt or purse. There you go. All right. Don't go away now. Larry, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
The very best of luck to you.
Thank you.
You will find in 12 or 13 years from now, all of these gifts will be coming your way. They're a little... Harry, Larry, don't leave when I'm talking to you. Larry, where are you going? All right. Peter, want to talk to me? We're going to send you some pantyhose and all kinds of wonderful things. And he left. Walk right out on me. What do you want? Oh,
I don't know.
We want some more Kleenex, but we all ran out of Kleenex. We've got to do a little commercial here, then hurry back and see what happens next. You know, it isn't very often that one of our celebrities brings parts of his family in here, and Peter Isaacson brought his mother in here, and I thought you'd like to see her. There she is, Lucille Isaacson down there. You're a very neat lady. Have a very gifted son.
Me everywhere.
She accompanies you everywhere.
She's my moral support.
Next time we get there.
Next time we get together.
Oh,
Peter Isaacson will not be here. However, in his seat, we will see
Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Linda Day George, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Beulafont.
And of course, Peter Isaacson will be back another time. So, with all of you, thank you, one and all. Gene Rayburn here, Tank Game 77. Tally ho!